Hey, it's Lori Ballen here in Las Vegas with 365 days of KW Command. The question was asked of me this morning, what is the difference between tasks and activities? And there are some differences that are very important to note. So we're going to go through this today. Now, you'll notice that tasks appear in your dashboard. Your home screen is actually customizable and you can move these around. By default, you're probably seeing these tasks up here at the left. Whenever you create a task, it shows up in this dashboard. Activities do not show up in the tasks dashboard. Now to the left here, you'll see we have contacts, which we're going to open in a moment, and then we have tasks. If you click on the tasks applet, what you're able to do is filter by contact tasks and opportunity tasks. You can view your to-do tasks, tasks that have been completed, and tasks that have been archived. So instead of deleted, we have them in the archive. All right. Now, you can also check a box to complete that task. So it warns you that when you check it, you're about to complete that task. Sorting here, you can show your tasks by today, past due, 7 days, 30 days, all time, okay? So these are your tasks. Now from here, you can click to create a new task. Basically, you can enter whatever you want to in this section. You can have a meeting, you can have a call, you can have a send a document, you can have send an email, send a text message. They're just basically task items that show up in your task list. Okay, now if you're assigning, creating a task from this section, you'll want to make sure that you go down here and click Associate Contacts and then pull up whoever the contact is so that it'll show up actually in their to-do as well. If you don't select that, it's not going to associate with any contact record and you won't know who that task was for. All right. So that is the basics of this. Now I'm going to go in and I'll show you more from the contact record. So if we open the contacts applet, you're going to be able to access your contacts. Now let's open Mr. Smith here. Okay, what you're going to notice if you look at the timeline is the difference in how things show up. Okay, now if I assign a task to Mr. Smith, it would show up here under task and it looks like this. From here, you're able to snooze the task or archive the task. This is a to-do. It appears in your tasks applet in the dashboard. It's a to-do. Activities, on the other hand, and I'll show you in a moment what those are, show up like this. It's just a note. The goal of activities is to record an interaction that is not otherwise recorded through a record of an email. So here's an example of a record of an email. This was an email that was sent through Gmail, and it just basically records that there was an email interaction there. If there was a text message here, you would also see that in the timeline. So an email automatically records the interaction, and a text message automatically records the interaction. A calendared meeting, if you use the calendar here, would also show an interaction. But let's just say you have a two-way interaction because you met that person for lunch or for coffee, but it wasn't a calendared event for some reason. You might actually want to make a note of that. So if we go up here to the plus sign that says add activity, or down at the bottom right, you can click the plus sign. You have three different options here. You have an activity, a note, and a calendared event. Now the difference here is a calendared event is going to show up on your calendar. So if you have associated your Google Calendar with this, you can calendar an event. You can also share an event. Let's go ahead and do one real quick so you can see where that shows up on the timeline as well. So I'm going to go to add a calendar event. Okay, appointment with Mr. Smith. Now let's pick a date. I'll just have that show up today. And I'm going to uncheck the all day so that I can actually list a time. And let's say this is going to be today at 1:15 to 1:45. Now I can do, I can add a notification to invite Mr. Smith if I want to from here. I can make other notes and hyperlinks. I'm going to go ahead and save this just as it is. Would you like to send an invitation to Mr. Smith? I'm going to put no at this time because Mr. Smith is just an example. So you can see here that it is showing up on the calendar. Okay. Now let's go back into Mr. Smith's contact record and refresh it. Okay. Now you don't see this on that right hand side. Let's go to timeline. There's nothing showing up there right now under timeline. Right. So it's not the same as it would be if we were assigning a task. Okay, so let's go to assign a task. So I'm going to go up here. I'm going to click the tasks, and I'm going to add a task. Meet with Mr. Smith. And this is going to be today. I can't remember what time we put. I'll just put 2 p.m. Create task. Let me go back to the timeline. Okay, so what you'll notice is this is a timeline of things that have occurred already. Opportunities are going to be your opportunity stages. Smart plans are the smart plans that they're in. Now, tasks are what are actually coming up. Here's notes that we've made. And then you have your saved searches. So your to-do tasks are going to show up over here. So let's go back to our tasks in our dashboard, meet with Mr. Smith. You'll notice that your calendared event is not in your task folder. That would be in your calendar. So you, learning these very clear differences in where things appear are going to make a major difference for you. So if you want a to-do to show up in your task list or a reminder, you might schedule that appointment on the calendar, and you might also set yourself as a to-do so that that's showing up here in your to-do dashboard right now. Okay. Now, in your customized home screen, yeah, I don't see the ability yet to add a calendar. So hopefully that's coming, because I think that would be, if we could put a calendar right here, that would make a significant difference for us as well. All right. So you're able to see, oh, meet with Mr. Smith at 2 p.m. That's right. Okay. Now, if you're looking at your Google calendar, you would see that anyway. So it just depends on how you want these things to show up in your dashboard. That's where it makes a significant difference. Now, let's say we already met with Mr. Smith. So check that box off. Click complete task. All right. Now, let's go back to Mr. Smith, the contact record, and take a look at it. I'm going to refresh it. Okay. So we don't see that task in the timeline here, but we do see it in our completed tasks. If we go to completed tasks. Okay. Now let's look at an activity. Okay. So your calendared event is not showing up here anywhere that I can see at this moment. But if you click view calendar, it will open your Google calendar, and that's where it would show up. Okay. And your tasks show up right here. So you can schedule any task. Now let's go to an activity so you can see the difference. Go to the plus sign. Again, the calendar. A note just simply adds anything you want. So it's not a two-way interaction. Maybe you want to make a note that Mike Smith's daughter graduates this month. You saw it on Facebook. And if you happen to talk to Mike Smith in the next few days, you would love to have this record, daughter graduates next month. Call notes. Okay. So see it show up right there? So you happen to be doing call arounds and you call Mike Smith and you look down at your notes like, oh, what's important? What if I talk to Mike Smith, what's going to be important? Okay, so you'll also see your notes here if you click on notes and just want to review your notes. Okay, now, so calendar puts it on the calendar. Whoops. Notes just makes any kind of a note. But an activity, this top one, is designed to record an interaction, a meeting, a call, a text, or a quick note that is not otherwise recorded. Okay? So you had a meeting with somebody and you want to record it. You could put had a meeting, March 31st, had coffee. Click Save. Now it shows up in your timeline as this highlighted yellow event. Okay? But it does not show up as a to-do, as a task. So if you instead put the plus sign and you put add activity and you have a meeting with them and you have a meeting with them on April 5th, having coffee, it will record it in the timeline under the correct date, but it does not add a task or to do. Okay, so if you had a call with them and your call was not recorded, talked about real estate, wants to buy next year, you're going to click Save. And it'll put it here as a phone call. Now, the phone call has a little bit of a different color to identify that type of activity. So, your meeting has that little calendar on it, your phone call has the phone icon. Okay, next activity is a text message. So, you might actually copy the text message here in the description. So, if you don't have Twilio installed and you're not texting through the system, but you want to record the text message, you would do that here. And you could see your little icon shows the text message. And I think there was one more, right? Quick note, just a note. All right, so there's your icon there. So it's basically creating notes in your timeline of what type of interaction you had. Just be careful about assuming that if you put a future date, that it sends you any type of alert or task or calendar. Okay? So I personally like activities for past events. They already happened, and I want to make a note because it's not already recording in any other way. I use notes just to add something that I saw in their timeline or something I might want to mention next time I talk to them, anything like that that's not a two-way interaction. Activities are, in my opinion, past, and tasks are future to-dos. That's the main differences that I see. So you really want to get a handle of learning where these show up so that you know how best to personally use your dashboard because they may not be the same for everybody. Thanks for joining me. Please subscribe to the channel, 365 Days of KW Command.